Ada yang benci dirinya, ada yang butuh dirinya, ada yang berlutut mencintainya, ada pula yang kejam menyiksa dirinya. Ini hidup wanita si kupu-kupu malang. Memanja kepada setiap mereka yang datang. Dosakah yang dia kerjakan? Sucikah mereka yang datang? Kadang dia butterfly. You have to repeat the word and then you put hyphen in between. There is which or what or that, because in Indonesian it is in one word, yang, and this one is there is, there is, there are, ada, or it is exist, ada, exist, ada, yang, which, that, who, whom, yang. Benci, hate. Diri, self. Nya, dirinya, it means her in this case, because in Indonesian there is no difference between he and she, or him, her. It is ia or dia, and in this case, because this becomes a suffix to make it like her, dirinya. Diri is self, nya is a suffix that means her or his or him, or also himself, herself, but in this case, there is or there are people who, whom, that, hate, her, or them in this case, because if it's more than one. And is also ada, there is, yang, it's the same, butuh, need, in this also the same, dirinya, in this case we translate it as her. This is also the same, and sometimes we write this word yang, that, which, who, whom, with these letters only. We pronounce it as yang, but we sometimes write it this way, but it is informal. You cannot write this in formal document. Lutut is knee, and we add the prefix ber, berlutut, it means kneel. cinta is love with the prefix me, and then because this one has letter C as initial, this prefix me, it has to be men. The rules of these prefixes and suffixes, I've already made a video. I will put the links below. Because sometimes it's me, sometimes it's men, sometimes it's also different. It depends on the initial of the word. Cinta, in this case we have to add the suffix I. Sometimes it's good enough if you add the suffixnya, mencintanya. It means love. Love that person, love her, loving her. Mencintainya, it's also loving her. Mencintanya, it means loving her or love her. But if you add the suffix, this one already have the suffixnya as her. Love her or loving her. This extra suffix I, in Indonesian we read this one not I but I. That's why my name is Ira, not Aira. Mencintainya instead of mencintanya, it means you love, you put emphasis that you love her or you loving her. Ada pula, and this one pula is a poetic or poem style word to say also, because we have other word for it, juga, but this is a song lyric, so we add this one, pula. It means also, and this one is the same, yang. Kejam, cruel. And this one, the base or basic word is siksa, torture, but we want to say torturing. We add the prefix me, because this one has letter S as initial, that's why the prefix me, it has to be men. The letter S, siksa, the S change into en, menyiksa. Torture or torturing, this one, it's the same, her. Ini hidup wanita si kupu kupu malam, bekerja bertaruh seluruh jiwa raga. This life, women, this si can be translated as the, but in Indonesian it's considered as a bit impolite if you add the C, because let's say someone say si Ira, it's gonna tend to belittle me when you add the C. If your position a bit higher in the hierarchy, let's say you're older, or that person, let's say you're junior or something, sometimes it is okay to say the C, but it's a bit belittle. So even though I translate this as the, but please don't use it because it is a bit impolite. This one, butterfly, night, kupu-kupu, malam. Kerja, work, and we add the prefix be. Ber, it has to be ber, the prefix itself, but this word has K as initial, and it is not berkerja, but it is bekerja. Also about these rules, I've already made videos about this, I will put the links below. And this one, bekerja is work, also working. Taruh itself, it means put, but if we add the suffix an, taruhan, it means bet. That's why this one bertaruh. We add the prefix ber. Bertaruh, it means bet. Taruh itself put, but if you add the an, taruhan is bet. And this one we add the prefix ber and then taruh, bertaruh, it means bet. And we can see here be and this one ber, because this one ker and this one taruh. It's this the rule. Seluruh, all. Jiwa, soul. Raga, body. Bibir, bibir senyum, kata halus merayu memanja kepada setiap mereka yang datang. Lips, bibir, senyum, smile, kata, word, halus, soft, rayu, merayu, we add the rayu and also we, when we add the prefix me, merayu, it means seduce. This one soft or fine or smooth. Manja, spoiled. Memanja, pamper. This one also the prefix me. Kepada, to. Setiap, every. Mereka, they or them, because in Indonesian whether it is subject or object, there's no difference. They or them, it's mereka. Yang, it's the same. That, which, who, whom, yang. Datang, come. Dosakah yang dia kerjakan? Sucikah mereka yang datang? Dosa, sin. When you add the suffix kah to make this word as a question, is it a sin? You add the kah. I kinda think this is from Japan, because in Japan when you want to change a word or sentence into a question, you add the ka, ka, and this one is ka, but this one is not a single word, this is a suffix. Dosa, sin. Dosa ka, is it a sin? That or who, whom, which, when in this case that, dia, she or he, in this case maybe a she, because yeah. Kerja, work, we add the suffix kan, kerjakan, done. Suci, holy. Kah, is it holy? Or are they holy? Holy, suci, because this one mereka. Again, this and this one come. Kadang, sometimes, dia, senyum, smile, ter, prefix ter, tersenyum, smile or smiling, dalam, in, tangis, cry. And this one also the same, sometimes he or she. As we can see here, the original basic word is tangis, cry, but we add the prefix me and it changed the initial, it becomes men, menangis. It's not metangis, but menangis. Again, the rules, I will put the videos links below. Di dalam, dalam is in or inside, and we want to make sure at the inside or in the inside, because this D can be translated as at, also in, also on. Dalam is in or inside, but if you want di dalam, it means in. Senyum, smile, you add the suffix an to make the smile, instead of as a verb, it becomes a noun. Senyuman, smile or smiles, as noun. Whether it is singular or plural, you add the suffix an, it becomes a noun. Oh, apa yang terjadi, terjadilah. This one, oh, it's the same when you say oh in English. Apa is what. This one is the same. Jadi can be so or can be, in this case we add the prefix ter. Terjadi, it means happened. Or what's that happened? Terjadilah. And this one is lah instead of kah. Lah is to put emphasize, to strengthen, to say yes, whatever it happens, just happened. Terjadilah. It is happening, it happens, it happens. Terjadilah. This one is the same, this one is the same. Tahu can be a food, tofu, but in this case is a verb, it means no. Tuhan, God. Sayang is love. We add the prefix pe, and this pe, it becomes peng. We can see here, when you add the prefix and the original or the base word initial letter is S, it becomes anj, anj. Any, not anj, any. Penyayang, it's not pesayang, but penyayang. Umat is people, but people, umat, when you say umat is more into religious, when it's with religion or God, you said people with umat. And this, we put hyphen because to say him, God, or his, because in Indonesian, him or his or her or she as object, or hers or his, him, we use nya, and his people, but his is God, so we put capital here, that's why you put hyphen. Then this one, repeat this one. This one is the same. She, no. Knows, but in Indonesia there's no difference, the verb is the same. Hanya, only or just. Hanyalah, to strengthen, to put emphasis. It is just, it is only. Sambung, connect, as we can see, any. Menyambung, connect. Nyawa, life. Ada yang benci dirinya. Ada yang butuh dirinya. Ada yang berlutut mencintainya. Ada pula yang kejam menyiksa dirinya. Ini hidup wanita si kupu-kupu malam. Bekerja bertaruh seluruh jiwa raga. Bibir senyum, kata halus merayu, memanja kepada setiap mereka yang datang. Dosakah yang dia kerjakan? Sucikah mereka yang datang? Kadang dia tersenyum dalam tangis. Kadang dia menangis di dalam senyuman. Oh, apa yang terjadi, terjadilah. Yang dia tahu, Tuhan penyayang umatnya. Yang dia tahu hanyalah menyambung nyawa. Ada yang benci dirinya, ada yang butuh dirinya, ada yang berlutut mencintainya, ada pula yang kejam menyiksa dirinya. Ini hidup wanita si kupu-kupu malam. Bekerja bertaruh seluruh jiwa raga. Bibir senyum, kata halus merayu memanja kepada setiap mereka yang datang. Dosakah yang dia kerjakan? Sucikah mereka yang datang? Kadang dia tersenyum dalam tangis, kadang dia menangis di dalam senyuman. Oh, apa yang terjadi, terjadilah. Yang dia tahu, Tuhan penyayang